Okay, y'all. This video is gonna be another personal video about how mentally I'm dealing with stuff. PTSD, memories, just feeling numb sometimes. And I'm being really completely honest and open. And that's, him helping, him getting help and advice on things. I just saw somebody's, walkway post, I'm not gonna go into it, but I'm just saying, was related to Me Too, and the confirmation hearing for, Flats, Supreme Court nomination. We all know what I'm talking about, I hope. But anyway, today I woke up just having, just feeling memories, mental flashbacks from working, and I have other memories and flashbacks, PTSD, everything just comes ahead. I just wish, like Fawn's post said, I wish we could know people and have memories and just seeing posts of theirs anywhere. Things don't come up in our minds and makes us fail a little. Like, for, I'm taking it easy, the safest and, by the way, first, like for work, I really do miss work. It's a Wednesday. I usually worked on Wednesdays. I miss my coworkers. I really am trying to be a better person and wishing them well, safe travels. But just some days I just have memories where I really loved my work and really loved what I did. And then the issue I had with the PC culture and PC police did not take a comment well. And advice, well, you all know what I'm talking about. I mentioned it a million times in the videos. And I also have a video on Facebook. Please don't look for it. Because I really want to go public. And the Red Cross asked me not to talk about work or anything. That's why I can't go public either. But I just really wish I could go back and work in some standards there. Another Red Cross in the area, because when I emailed one of my bosses through the armed forces, she was completely shocked. She didn't even know what happened. So I told her to talk to the volunteer doctor at Red Cross. I just really don't think what my actions warranted what happened. And I just really miss my coworkers. I wish they trusted me. They knew me by then. That person really walked my comment. That's what I say, walked it. I just wish my Red Cross coworkers believed I did not mean harm in it. So that's where I was today, just mentally and emotionally missing my coworkers. Because that was the Wednesday, work on Wednesdays. But on the other side, it's about my past room. Sometimes I just wonder if the memories, the PTSD, the feelings I have about it just disappear. And some of the issues I have is mentally, physically, emotionally connecting with this, my boyfriend. Like, when we've been going out since July, same July, but we officially dated, started dating in August. And I just really want to progress this relationship. And thankfully, we both agree that it will take time. It's no rush. However, just some days, some, like, the last several months, I just felt numb. And I really known this person for 30 years, and I did have feelings for him in the beginning. And from a few years, he's a great guy, romantic, loving, very attractive, the involved, and I'm attracted to his heart, his personality, his mind, and just not his body, because I'm just freaking out where intimacy goes, and also just the memories of being such an abused witch for 3 years is affecting me, and a few people said it will take time, take baby steps, hold hands, hug. The thing is, we've been just giving each other goodbye hugs, and I really don't feel anything. I just really do care about him. I do really have feelings for him. I always have. Just physically, it's just not moving quick enough for me. Mentally, just scares me to death, physically doing things. I would appreciate if some people just leave comments and word of encouragement, and even though I know some people have survived what I've been through, and they moved on and had a happy life, marriage and kids, even people who had abused not longer than I have, I would like them people to really help me, even if they're not mentally and emotionally involved with people yet. I just appreciate any comments, inspiration, comments that really will help me heal and move on with my relationship. And I know a few people in the Rockaway movement, anybody who doesn't know Rockaway should look at the videos. You will learn a thing or two about the Democrats and the Liberals. But anyway, I don't want any of those people who comment on my stuff, because these people are so hateful, so angry, and anti-Christ that they would be willing to destroy and devastate people's lives and a Me Too moment. They're brainwashed to have their stories. I don't know if they know what private parts or what, where's an okay place to touch, Also, cat cows are not sexual harassment. It compliments ladies or guys. All they are is just words encouraging you that you are worth it and you're beautiful and you're pretty. It's not sexual harassment. And that's, even jokes are not sexual harassment. And private parts are not shoulders, backs, heads, legs. And if you get orgasm from that, it's your goddamn fault. And also, if you had such a advances, like I said in the Me Too video, and dress like a slut, you're asking to be a slut, and you're being easy to pry on. So sorry if I'm not one of you guys, but I am not one. Me Too movement. I'm a Kids Too movement with Corey Feldman, who's doing things right, and he doesn't even lie. False statements in his. But anyway, like I said, this is kind of a self-help advice, call for help, and would like some advice how to get involved with somebody after being raped or sexually abused. What have you done? And what helped you get through it and helped you move on? Thank you a lot.